Today we're moving into chapter 3 of the book of the prophet Nehemiah. I love the picture that's portrayed in this chapter and simply would ask you to read through the whole chapter yourself, please. The work of building and rebuilding these walls and putting in place the gates has got underway. Groups of people are working in their own patch, working outside their own front door, as it were, but also working in other parts of the city as well. They're using their gifts and their skills and their talents, and at the same time, many of them are also learning new skills and new gifts and new talents. Hundreds have responded to Nehemiah's invitation and challenge to join in this work of rebuilding. Indeed, thousands probably have joined in this work of rebuilding. So do try reading through the full chapter to get that picture. And as you read through it, be really encouraged, as I was whenever I read through it. Another picture comes to mind, though, for me, and it's a picture of our diocese and of our churches and of our towns and cities and rural communities, of our parish churches, of our church plants, and people working together, people pulling together, people using their gifts and their skills, and others learning new gifts and new skills in the task of building for God and rebuilding for God. In this chapter, the people start at the sheep gate at the northeast end corner of the wall, providing an easy way into the temple. So they prioritize worship. They prioritize a place for worship. And they make it easy and safe for people to worship God. And they make that their priority. Let's make that our priority these days, that we make it safe for people to worship. And that we provide ways, creative ways, in today's world whereby all and everyone has the opportunity to worship. The spiritual leaders in this chapter, they take the lead. The priests themselves, the Levites, take the lead. As Alec Mateer writes, these Jerusalem priests wanted to be as good as their message, so they committed themselves eagerly to the work, and in so doing, encouraged the enthusiasm of their neighbors. These are days when we need to be looking towards leaders and seeing leaders emerge. And also the church needs to be identifying and encouraging and equipping and enabling new leaders to be raised up in our churches. A whole new generation of leaders needs to emerge in our church in the days that lie ahead. Women and men that will go forward for ordination in the years that lie ahead. New Sunday school teachers, new children and youth workers, new people that will work with men and raise up men's ministries, new people that will work with women and raise up ministries for women, teachers, evangelists, prophets, apostles, pastors, so that our church is built and rebuilt. You have in this picture, and we need to see emerging in our churches and in our diocese, workers that are skilled, working alongside those that are unskilled, young and old, men and women working together in the task of building and rebuilding God's church. I believe we're in a day and we're in a moment where we need to be really leaning into that, praying into that, prioritizing that in the life and work of our church in this day and in this moment. I'm going to pray a prayer from the Book of Common Prayer that is used in the days, what's called Ember Days, but it's a prayer that we should maybe visit a lot more often. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of the church is governed and sanctified, hear our prayer, which we offer for all your faithful people, that in their vocation and ministry, we may serve you in holiness and truth, to the glory of your name, through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And I wonder if today there are some who are listening to this brief little thought and devotion, and the Lord would be putting his finger upon your heart and calling you to some form of ministry, perhaps even to ordained ministry, maybe to become a lay reader or an evangelist or a Sunday school teacher or a youth worker, maybe to work among men, maybe to work among women. I would want to say to you, explore that. Seek that. Don't set that thought to one side, but allow the Holy Spirit to be more and more at work in your life, bringing about that calling that he may well be placing upon your life in this moment. And so I pray, Holy Spirit, call into ministry in our day and in our generation men and women who will serve your world, who will build up your church, and Lord, who will give glory and honor and praise to your holy name. Raise up, Lord, a whole new generation of leaders, we pray, for our church and for our world in these days. Godly men and women who will lead for Christ and will lead like Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.